Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm glad that you are with us. Welcome to our talk on Continental Smart Air Springs, a smart technology that was developed by Continental Advanced Dynamic Solutions. Air springs are frequently used within the industrial field. As you probably know, they often have to withstand high pressure and fast accelerations. But did you also know that most operators usually do not have any insight on the condition nor performance of their air springs? This missing information can be useful, though, not only for performance optimization, but in particular for predictive maintenance. To tackle this issue, Continental developed smart air springs by turning usual air springs into intelligent ones. But before we dive deeper into the topic and hear what makes Continental's air springs so smart, let's give a warm welcome to our expert of today's session, Manuel Mosich. Hi, Manuel.
Hello, Alyosha.
And before we start, an important note, we all were tested negative for COVID in the morning, so all of us are safe. Manuel, as head of digital solutions for industrial applications at Continental, you are working on the development of smart solutions for the industrial area. Why do you think it's necessary to change conventional goods like air springs?
Yes. Well, Continental air springs are working extremely reliable since many years in various applications. Due to their robustness and their outstanding lifetime performance, they are used often under extreme and challenging conditions. For example, in suspension systems for transportation, agricultural, construction, or railway vehicles. Air springs are used in the mining industry, the white or wood industry, in the automation industry. The field of industrial applications is very broad. But all these applications have one thing in common. They are all impacted by the trends of digitalization and Industry 4.0. And this goes hand in hand with an increasing level of automatization and high demands for connectivity and data generation. More and more operators ask us for opportunities to perform condition monitoring. So we see clearly that this transformation proceeds in the different industries at different speeds, but it proceeds definitely. And the vision of Industry 4.0 is more reality than ever before.
In which areas do you use air springs usually? And do air springs still meet the need of industry today?
Yeah. Air springs are in use whenever heavy loads need to be lifted or a high-performance vibration isolation is required. Here we have some examples for applications with air springs in the industrial environment. Here we see a press machine for metal forming. Here the air spring compensates huge loads to move this heavy tool up and down. Another example are industrial screening machines for material separation. Here the air spring is impacted by very strong vibrations. And these machines are running 24 hours, 7 days per week. Another example are industrial washing machines. Here we are again impacted with strong vibrations, fast rotations, and we have a big difference between the loaded and the unloaded condition. So the question is, why do engineers use air springs for their machines? Air springs are very simple to install, and they are extremely reliable in operation. And air springs have some technical characteristics that are really unique on the market. So all well so far. The air spring is a great product. But there are a few things that air springs were not able to do until now. Air springs were not able to communicate with a machine control unit. An air spring was not able to tell you anything about its current condition. Every air spring has an air inlet, but there was no additional interface for communication with other devices. And to be part of the digitalization in all industries, two things are essential. You need a communication channel and you need the right language. In best case, you speak the language that is spoken by the connected devices around you. But so far, neither the communication channel nor the language was available. So we can say that our air spring, our simple air spring, was not able to talk to its digital neighbors.
Okay, let's talk about the communication channel. How is it implemented in the smart Airsprings from Continental, and what is the technology all about?
Yes, the solution that enables us to be connected to this digital world is the integrated sensor technology. And here we see our Continental HPTA sensor for industrial airsprings. This sensor is integrated into one of the connecting plates of an airspring, and it provides two interfaces. We have the electric connection for the communication we talked about, and of course we have the pneumatic connection for the air supply. So HPTA, what does it mean? HPTA stands for the four different measurement values: height, pressure, temperature, and acceleration. And with this integrated sensor unit, our airspring transforms from a very classic and conservative product to a real data source that enables engineers and operators to benefit from completely new opportunities.
Okay, let's move forward from theory to reality. As we all can see, you brought one smart airspring with you to the studio. So what do we see, and where do we find the HPTA sensor?
Yes, now we come to the more entertaining part, and we are very lucky that we have this small double convoluted airspring here with us. And as in the picture before, the integrated HPTA sensor is here in the top connecting plate of our airspring. Here we see the electronic connection for the communication, and besides to this, we have the air inlet. And just to give you an impression what this small airspring here can do, with 8 bar inner pressure, this airspring here can carry more than 1,000 kilograms. And the stroke from minimum to maximum height is more than 100 millimeters. So, but the essential thing for today is the integrated sensor technology. And by this, the ability to provide the information of the current condition of this airspring. And with this information, we are able to create a digital twin. And this is what we see here on the screen. If we put now some load on the airspring, we can see the reaction of the digital twin, and we see the reaction of the four measurement values accordingly to the movement of our real airspring.
There's so much to talk about. Let's talk about the four measurement values, starting with the first one, its height. What can you tell us about that?
Yes, of course. Let us start with a height measurement. So when I push down the airspring, we can see that the height measurement curve moves also up and down, similar to the movement of the airspring. So we can draw some nice curves, a great toy for engineers. But why is it so interesting for the engineers? Height measuring is widely used for airspring systems because airsprings have different operating heights under different loads. And this is relevant for passenger cars, for trucks, for railway vehicles, or for industrial isolation platforms. Because all these examples are more or less a four-point mounting frame. And the task for this frame is always the same. You always want to hold this system in a horizontal position. Imagine you have a platform, and the load is moving from one side to the other side. The platform will go down on this side, but we will recognize it because of our height measurement function. The pneumatic control system will now adapt the inner pressure of all air springs in that way that the platform goes back to the horizontal position. And this is a very simple and general example for what this height measurement function can be used.
Next function, it's pressure, I think, right?
Exactly. The next function is a pressure function. Pressure is the operating medium for every airspring. The pressure range for the airsprings is usually between 0 to 8 bar. So now I will close the system. When the system is closed, you will see that it's not so easy anymore for me to push down the airspring, but now I can create some inner pressure. So I will try my best, and we can see that I can create 200, maybe 300 millibar. So now you can imagine how much load you can put on the airspring until you reach the maximum pressure of 8,000 millibar. But okay, back to the topic, pressure measurement. Why is pressure measurement so important for airsprings? Well, a pressure control is often used to move the airspring up and down. Sometimes external pressure sensors are in use. And very often, pressure monitoring is a required safety feature to ensure that the maximum operating pressure is never exceeded. And all these functions can be realized with the pressure function of our HPTA sensor.
HPTA, next one is T, and T stands for temperature.
Temperature, exactly. Temperature we see in the top right corner. And the temperature range for air springs is usually from minus 60 to plus 70 degrees, so a wide range. So unfortunately, I have now no cooling or heating equipment here with me, and so I cannot change really the temperature. But we can see that we have very comfortable, little bit more than 20 degrees here in our studio as our room temperature. And can imagine that temperature tracking always helps also to ensure that we stay inside the range we are allowed to. And we can, for example, get a signal or warning when we are outside our temperature range.
Last one, it's acceleration. So please give us all about acceleration.
Exactly. HPTA, A for acceleration. And acceleration values are very exciting. They are often the basis for predictive maintenance. Air springs are often used as isolators. So in many applications, they are impacted by a lot of vibrations. Therefore, the acceleration level is of very high interest in many applications. So usually, you have a low level of accelerations inside your application when your machine is running properly. This could be the current status. At the moment, we see nearly no activities for our acceleration values. But now I will simulate some vibrations. We can see in the diagram some increasing acceleration values. And if this level exceeds the normal level significantly, this is an indication that you have to check your machine.
There is a load measurement in the middle of the dashboard. What does it do? I know it's a favorite one of yours, right?
Yeah, exactly. This is a very good question. And on the basis of the four measurements, we can calculate further values that can be very helpful. For example, we can calculate vibration frequencies, vibration amplitudes, or for some applications, it can be very interesting to count the load cycles of the airspring. And we can calculate the load on the current airspring in reality. And I mentioned before that this small airspring can carry more than 1,000 kilograms. So you can imagine I cannot realize this, but I will do my best to put some load on the airspring. And we will see, I can see that I can generate 30, maybe 40 kilograms. Try again. A little bit more than 40 kilograms. And now imagine you have a machine. And during operation, you have to put different materials on your machine. And your machine has a maximum load of maybe 500 kilograms. If your machine is intelligent, it will give you a signal or a warning when you are near or even above this maximum load. And this is exactly what you can do with this solution.
Perfect. I think we all know now what smart means when we're talking about smart air springs from Continental. So if our viewers are now interested in that technology, in the smart air springs from Continental, what do they need for the installation, especially regarding data transmission and processing?
Yeah, for data transmission and processing, you need a machine control unit with a suitable interface in the background. Currently, we use a digital output signal called RS485 to transfer all data from the sensor to our control unit. So if everything is connected, all information we showed before is available and can be integrated into the customer's individual software. There it can be processed and visualized together with other data, everything accordingly to the customer needs, because this will be very different from application to application. And for general questions around the sensor implementation, our engineering team can support with our Airspring and our software competence. And additionally, we developed the HPTA starter kit. This is a small case, yeah, we see it here, and it includes exactly this Airspring with the integrated HPTA sensor, and it includes a USB adapter to connect it to your laptop and the software for data logging. So with this case, everyone can experience the sensor functions in the same way we did it today. And if you want to, you can test it directly in your own real applications. After this, you can have a look to the data and you can decide if it makes sense to have this data and this opportunity for your daily work.
Perfect. So if the data is integrated in the IoT, can you add that digital twin to existing systems?
Yes, of course. And this is already what customers do. Customers use already digital twins of whole machines or complex systems. And our Airspring can now be an active part of these smart solutions. And it can extend the opportunities for all engineers and operators. In the end, it's all about to simplify condition monitoring. And it helps to execute your processes as safe and efficient as possible. This is a very good example for our ContiTech vision of smart and sustainable solutions.
Manuel, my last question, it's a personal one. What is your personal opinion regarding these digital trends in the industry?
Well, we all use more and more digital systems and tools in our daily life. And we are not always forced to it. And we use it because it's easier, faster, sometimes it's cheaper, sometimes it's just cool to do it in the digital way. So for me personally, this is the reason why the digital transformation is moving forward and will keep moving forward in the future. More and more people are convinced of this new technology and are willing to experience them. And our job at Continental is to make our classic products ready for these new requirements.
Perfect. Thank you so much, Manuel, for being with us. It's an important and very excited topic
Thank
that we're
much.
Talking about. So thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Manuel, thanks. And what's best about it, ladies and gentlemen, it wasn't Continental's last session yet. Tomorrow we will be back at 11:30 a.m., starting with our two experts, Benedikt Gruder and Pierre Pomper, who will be introduced to us autonomous mobile robots in Industry 4.0. I'm looking forward to seeing you there. Till then, be safe and have a great day.